Good morning to all the students. In the last class, we explained about the nuclear fusion and also we gave some basics about the radioactivity. Actually, the concept radioactivity, which is also one of the nuclear phenomena, and according to your this year portion or this year syllabus, this radioactivity actually it is deleted, but there may be few CET questions they may ask based on the radioactivity. For that purpose here we will discuss about the phenomena of radioactivity, then radioactive decay law, then expression for number of atoms which are present in the radioactive sample at the instant of time, that is n equal to n0 e to the power minus lambda t. Then next, half-life period of radioactive element, that is T half equal to 0.693 divided by lambda. And also we have to know about the mean life or average life, that is T mean. This we have to go for these concepts. So here the radioactivity is one of the nuclear phenomena in which the spontaneous disintegration of heavy nuclei, by the emission of certain radiations called radioactivity. Here the naturally occurring radioactivity is called natural radioactivity, and artificially occurred radioactivity is known as artificial radioactivity. Natural radioactivity was discovered by Henry Becquerel. Whereas artificial radioactivity was discovered by Irving Curie Joliet and Frederick Joliet. So here only we are going to learning about the natural radioactivity which was discovered by Henry Becquerel. Therefore, the activity of radioactive element can be measured in terms of Becquerel. Later, about the radioactivity, it was explained by Curie also. After the discovery of radium and polonium. Now we are already know what I said, the spontaneous disintegration of heavy nuclei by the emission of certain radiations. And the radiations are here, alpha radiations means alpha rays, beta radiations means beta rays, and gamma radiations are nothing but gamma rays. Here alpha rays are alpha radiations which consists of positively charged particles, and they are identified as helium nuclei. Whereas the beta radiations are the negatively charged particles, and they are identified as negatively charged particles which are nothing but electrons. Alpha particles are heavy. They are having a large mass which is equal to the mass of the helium nuclei. Beta particles are beta radiations which consists of a beta particles, and they are negatively charged. They are identified as electrons. They are very very light particles. And gamma radiations are neutral particles. Gamma radiations consists of neutral particles, and they are identified as no charge. Charge on the gamma experiment in which the electric field or a magnetic field are applied, and the magnetic field or electric field what it will be applied to the radioactive element, then some of the radiations are reflecting towards the positively charged plate. For example, here is the positively charged plate and here is the negatively charged plate, and here is the a lead block in which a radioactive sample will be placed. This is the radioactive sample, radioactive sample, and this radioactive sample will be disintegrated with the emission of certain radiations, and the radiations are, they are going to deflecting towards the, few radiations are deflecting towards the negatively charged plane. Few are deflecting towards the negatively charged plane. Few they are deflecting towards the positively charged plane. Few are deflecting towards the positively charged plane. And some they never deflect, they move free. Here the some radiations they are deflecting towards the negative charge plane. Then these radiations they consist of a particles and they are positively charged because of the fundamental property of the electric charges. Charge is attractive if the charges are unlike, and repulsive if the charges are like. Means like charges repel each other and like charges attract each other. So here the radiations which consists of a particles, they are deflecting towards the negatively charged plane, means it consists of a positively charged particles. Later it will be identified as helium nucleus. And the radiations, they consist of a particles which are deflecting towards the positively charged plane, and they are identified as negatively charged particles. Whereas the some radiations they never deflect, they move straight. That means they are not affected by electric field and also magnetic field. If they are not affected by electric and magnetic field, that means the particles which consist of a gamma radiations, they are neutral particles. So like this, here is the phenomenon of this radioactivity. This it was explained by Rutherford, but natural activity it was discovered by Henry Becquerel. And here there are few properties of radioactive radiations, alpha, beta and gamma radiations. It has a less penetrating power, but ionization power will be very large, and this one is penetrating power will be more than 110 than that of the alpha, but ionization power will be less, and for this penetrating power will be very high, large penetrating power, which is about 100 times greater than that of the beta, whereas the ionization power will be very less. As the penetrating power is increases, the ionization power will be decreased. Such there are few properties which you are going to learning in radioactivity. Radioactivity are one of the properties of radioactive elements. Few now I explain: alpha positively, beta negatively, gamma electrically neutral. Alpha and beta, they are affected by both electric and magnetic fields, whereas the gamma, they are not affected by electric and magnetic fields. Alpha radiations are having a ionization power is more, penetrating power will be less. Beta ionization power will be about 100 times less, whereas the penetrating power is 100 times greater than that of alpha. Similarly, gamma is more penetrating power. It is more than 100 times than that of the beta, whereas the ionization power will be very less, which is 100 times less than that of beta. This is about the few properties of radioactive radiations. Now we want to see here radioactive decay law or disintegration. Radioactive decay law. This can also be called as disintegration law. अर्थात disintegration law अंतर अथवा radioactive decay law. So here is the radioactive element. Usually keep it in mind, the radioactive elements are the heavy nuclei and they are unstable. Radioactive elements, heavy nuclei, so mass number is very large. Large mass number is the binding energy kadime irthada, hence they are unstable agirthava. Avu unstable adaga they are going to disintegrating. During the disintegration, there is a change in mass number of that radioactive sample. So therefore, this law states that the rate of disintegration, rate of disintegration is directly proportional to number of atoms present in the radioactive sample. This is what the decay law, radioactive decay law. That is a rate of disintegration is dN by dt, directly proportional to number of atoms which are present in the sample. That is dN by dt is proportional to N. Now this dN by dt equal to some constant lambda into N. Here we will write it by the radiation. Here lambda is a proportionality constant. And this proportionality constant is called decay constant. Decay constant. That is the proportionality constant. And here what the negative sign we got it. And this negative sign is because of number of atoms in the sample. Number of atoms in the radioactive sample decreases with increase of time. Negative sign represents number of atoms in the sample. In the sample decreases with increase of time. For that purpose we are going to write in here is the negative sign. This is according to the radioactive decay law. We got it N by dt equal to minus lambda in. Now using this relation, we are going to find in how many number of atoms which are present in the sample at the instant of time t. At the instant of time, how many number of atoms which are present in the sample. For that we have to get the expression, and that is N equal to N naught e to power minus lambda t. So just I will show you briefly. And better to observe carefully. If possible, you can do the practice for that. Here is the question. Obtain an expression for N equal to N naught e to power minus lambda t. Question will be like this. Obtain an expression for N equal to N naught e power minus lambda t. So according to the radioactive decay law, we have dN by dt equal to minus lambda into N, where N is the number of atoms which are present in the sample at the instant of time, at the instant of time. And n naught represents actually the number of atoms which are present in the sample before disintegration. That means when t equal to 0, when t equal to 0, n equal to n naught, then t is equal to t, n will be the number of atoms. After a certain time, the number of atoms which are present in the sample is n. When time is 0, means before disintegration, number of atoms will be represented by n. That means the particle or number of atoms will be varying from n naught to n when the time t is 0 to t. 0 to t are n naught to n naught. That's why we have to say dn by n equal to minus lambda into dt by class integration. Now taking integration with limits or that much can go. Here integral dn by n equal to integral minus lambda dt. Here the limits n to n naught we will go, otherwise we will do like that and taking the integral constant of the topology to one two mark. The integration or differentiation that can be made only for the variables, not for the constants. Here n and t are the variables, whereas the lambda is constant, and this lambda better to take it outside. This we will write it as integral 1 by n with respect to n equal to minus lambda integral dt. Now integral of 1 by n with respect to n is log n to the base e equal to minus lambda into integral of 1 with respect to dt. So therefore here we will get t will be the t plus some integral constant k plus some integral constant. So that means we got it log n to the base e equal to minus lambda t plus k. Now here n equal to n naught when t is equal to 0. Then what this equation and what the k we will get out? And here is log of in place of n naught to the base e equal to minus lambda t plus k, therefore log n naught to the base e equal to k. Then go for again k here, you have to substitute. What will get? Log n to the base e equal to minus lambda t plus log, here k is nothing but how much you got it? Log n naught to the base e. By the rearrangement, log n to the base e, take it towards LHS, it becomes minus log n naught to the base e equal to minus lambda t. According to the properties of logarithms, log m minus log n, that can be written as log m minus n. Log m minus n equal to log m by n. So therefore it becomes log n by n naught to the base e equal to minus lambda. By taking nth log, so we will get n by taking nth log, n by n naught equal to e to the power minus lambda t. Then n equal to, therefore, n equal to n naught e to the power minus lambda t. This is the required equation. I don't need to require. This is one of the equations. So this we want. Then next what we want here? Half life period. Next equation is another thing. One thing. The next we know half life. Actually keep in mind these deviations are not for your syllabus, particularly for this year. But in case of a object retired, in case of a NEET and JEE, they may ask the question based on this. For that purpose, I am going to be giving these concepts. Others of life prevail of radioactive sample which is represented by the capital T or T suffix half. So here half life prevail is the time during which 50% of number of atoms will be disintegrated from the sample, or 50% of atoms present in the sample. For that, for the time it will be required, that time will be called as half life period. So therefore here half life period is defined as the time required to disintegrate 50% of atoms from the sample. Example, radioactive sample. That is N equal to N naught by 50% means 1 by 2, because of 50% of N naught is 1. 50% of N naught, which is equal to 50 divided by 100 N naught, which is equal to N naught by 2. When T equal to T half, like, know what the equation is. Oh, N equal to N naught e to the power minus lambda T become what it will be. That's better to see. Other than known. So here, N equal to N naught by 2 equal to power minus lambda t is nothing but what? T half. T n is equal to T. Now here n naught, n naught it cancel, 1 by 2 equal to e to power minus lambda t. So here by converting numerator becomes denominator, this negative sign becomes positive. You know it in mathematics, some rules will be there. According to that it becomes 1 by 2 equal to e to power minus lambda t, it becomes 2 equal to e to power lambda t. Again by applying the log here we will get log 2 to the base e equal to lambda t half. This is the log applied to the base. To the base e can be replaced by base 10 by multiplying 2.303. This is log 2 to the base 10 answer to lambda t half. Now 2.303 take the log 2 to the base 10. The value note could be the value of the 0.3010. This value is now. And this is equal to lambda t half. If you multiply these two, you get 0.693 equal to lambda into T half. Therefore, T half equal to 0.693 divided by lambda. This is what the expression for half-life period of radioactive element. T half equal to 0.693 divided by. If you will go for the graph which is plotted, number of atoms against half life, well, time t, this is t actually, t. Here is first half life. This is 2 times of half life. This is 3 times of half life. And 4 times of, 5 times of half life. When t equal equal to 0 means here the number of atoms present in the sample is equal to n. That means initial number of atoms. And for this here is the number of atoms. This is n. When t is goes to half, half life period. For half life period, how many number of atoms here goes to 50%. 50% means here is the 100%. Illi study panni 100. Illi 50%. Illi 25%. Illi 12.5%. Like this. Half, 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 half. So, for first half life, illi panni omigadu, illi dirpo, char number of particles even. For which one? For first half. Here. For next half life, 50% or not 50% average becomes 25. For next half life, either is 25%, either 25 third half. Here. For next half life, either that zero average. Then join these points. This is what the curve obtained by plotting the number of atoms present in the sample during the half-life period. And the first half life is equal to T half equal to 50%. Next to T half, and we do 1/2. Next to second, it is 50% and 25%. This is Arda, 1 by 2 Arda, equal to 1 by 2. Next, third half. This is 50%, means 12.5%. This is the half of the 1 by 2. But the fourth half is. This is Arda, 6.25%. This is Arda, 1 by 60. Next, 5 half is. 5 half is. This is Arda, 3.125%. Iska half, iska matlab 1/32. Andre enagidu 1/2 to the power 1/2, idu 1/2 to the power 2/2, idu 1/2 to the power 3 aitu, idu 1/2 to the power 4 aitu, idu 1/2 to the power 5 aitu. Inchita adu radiation of number of atoms which are present in the radioactive sample in terms of half-life period. This is about the concept of half-life period of radioactive sample. Next, one more is what T mean. T mean average life.
Time of all atoms
Then later we will go for the new ones. Okay, thank you.